Hello students, let us continue with the chapter 8, motion. We had discussed in the previous two lectures distance, displacement, motion, rest, and difference between distance and displacement and speed itself. And moreover, we had also discussed motion, uniform motion, that is, and non-uniform motion. So now let us continue with the speed, that is average speed. Average speed means, suppose one object is moving with the speed 20 meter per second and the second object is moving with the speed 20 meter per second. So in that case we are to find average speed. That means we will add both the speeds, right, and divided by 2. So that means if one speed is v and second one is u, so average speed is equal to v plus u upon t, right? Then come to velocity means the speed in a particular direction. Or if we talk about velocity in mathematical form or in mathematical definition, so this is equal to displacement upon time, right? Then displacement, its formula is displacement upon time. So if we talk about its units, so as you know, SI unit of displacement is meter and time is second, that means meter per second, which is the same as the speed, units of speed. So since displacement is a vector quantity, that means velocity is also a vector quantity, right? Then since displacement can be zero, that means velocity can be zero. So next, suppose we are to write average velocity also, if it is uniform, then we can also use v plus u upon t. So, or if the time is same but distance is same but time is different, in that case we will apply formula 2v1 v2 upon v1 plus v2. So that is the case in case if it is not uniform, right? Now come to acceleration. Acceleration means rate of change of velocity with respect to time. So acceleration is then v change in velocity, yani velocity upon time. Actually rate of change of mean the quantity which is changing with respect to the time. So acceleration, velocity upon time. And let us talk about its units. Units, as you know, as just we have derived its unit meter per second velocity, then just put it here, meter per second upon second. So it will be a meter per second square, or you can write it like that, meter per second square. This is the acceleration. So now since velocity is a vector quantity, that means acceleration should be also acceleration is also a vector quantity, right? So if suppose an object is moving with a particular velocity and after some time its velocity is decreasing, so that means in that case velocity will be negative, or we get acceleration in the value of acceleration is negative. So in that case we will say that if the object has decelerated, or we can say it is a retardation. So let us talk about formula for the calculation of this acceleration quantity. So acceleration means just I have explained this, rate of change of velocity, that means change in velocity v minus u upon t, where v is equal to final velocity and u is equal to initial velocity. u is equal to initial velocity, right? Suppose it is not uniform, means a person is driving a car or any vehicle on the main highway road. So he is not applied to brake because there is no obstacle or nothing else. So in that case, his motion is uniform. Its speed is moving with the speed same. But if that particular person passes through a area where a crowd is there, or anything else comes in front of the driver who is driving the car or any vehicle, so he has to apply brake. That means he has decelerated. So that means velocity decreases. Velocity decreases means this velocity is more, and this velocity means initial velocity is more than that of final velocity. In that case, we get acceleration negative, and negative acceleration is retardation. This is a more important term. This is retardation, means negative acceleration. So now let us discuss how to solve the numericals, whether we are interested to find velocity or acceleration. So for acceleration, suppose statement is given, right? Any object or any vehicle starting from rest. So in that case, you have to note it down. Whenever object is started from the rest, in that case, we are to take initial velocity is zero. This will help you a lot to find the numericals, to solve the numericals. Or suppose a driver applies the brakes and that vehicle comes to rest. So that means in that case V is equal to zero. So we are to take velocity zero, final velocity zero, when a car stops after the application of brakes. But if an object is starting from the rest, we are to take U is equal to zero. So in that case, we can able to find the acceleration of a particular object, right? So thank you, students. In the next video, we will discuss some numerical related to acceleration, and no doubt we are still left with equations of motion which are 3 in number. We will prove that, and some examples we will practice. Till then, goodbye.